Gentlemen, some great insights there. Right, so we move on to our final presentation of the day, which is Adarsh from Millennium Hotels. And this is a brand that's really worked with us for a number of years now, and have had a kind of interesting kind of brand evolution and some challenges through that. And Adarsh, who is kind of focused on digital marketing and is the corporate director of digital at Millennium, is going to come up and tell you a little bit about that story. So please join me in welcoming on stage.
Thanks, Simon. Firstly, I would like to thank Mark Monitor for giving me an opportunity to, you know, come and share my thoughts about brand protection in the digital space. I work, as Simon introduced, I work as a head of digital marketing for Millennium Hotels and Resorts. We've got about 130 plus hotels spread across four different brands in five regions. Globally. For the next, I'll briefly be talking about what we are doing from Millennium Hotels to overcome the brand equity threats that we have. The hotel industry and the solutions that we have put in place from the hotel industry perspective. The distribution landscape in the hotel industry is quite a complex one. As you all know, there's plenty of technology innovations that's happened. The consumer behavior has been changing, which means that the users have plenty of options to choose where they make their bookings from. And I'm sure this continues to evolve going forward as well. For us, from a marketing perspective, we want to touch upon every digital touch point a user goes through to try and influence them and try to make get them to stay with us, basically. But because the network itself is quite a complex one, we have various technology integrations, we have various marketing channels, we have various partners that we work with, it's slightly difficult to enforce brand protection across all of these channels. One of the biggest issue that we have in the hotel industry is rate parity. Rate parity is basically when the hotel industry, when we started working with various distribution partners like OTAs, for example, we had clauses in the contracts which, didn't allow the OTA partners to undersell than what we were selling on the brand website. Now, this was something that the hotel industry asked of our distribution partners, but now things are changing. The hotel industry has woken up. They've identified the need to get more users to interact directly with the brand, which means that the very rate parity question that we had been enforcing with our partners, we want to have disparity there. Basically, we want to sell lower, but we can't do it because we're contractually obliged with some of the partners that we work with. Customers also, they get various different channels that they access, and they always get some sort of loyalty discount if you're working with OTAs, for example. It makes it very difficult, and disparity cuts into hotels' profits and also impacts the brand reputation in a bit. I missed all the slides, I think. So I just wanted to give you a brief glimpse of what our distribution network looks like. I think this was 3 or 4 years ago when we decided to understand who our partners are, who do we work with, and what our distribution network looks like. We realized that it's quite a complex one. We have multiple layers within our distribution network. We have ranging from property management systems to the marketing itself. The different marketing channels that we work with. We have some channels which are extremely big, some channels which are quite small. We try and integrate with all of them. From a technical perspective, we have plenty of API integrations, and it makes it extremely complex for us to ensure that everything that we are distributing through these partners are following a set brand guidelines, for example. Sorry, give me a second. If we had to look back a few years ago, I think there were clear and distinct channels that the hotel industry worked with. We were very clear on the direct channels being the brand website, for example, or the direct channels being the online travel aggregators, or meta search channels, for example. But those things have changed now simply because there's a lot of onward distribution from our partners. We supply rates to some of the distribution partners that we work with. They distribute those rates to further down the food chain, basically, which makes it extremely complex. And we don't have relationships or we don't have partnerships with everyone that we work with. We have partnerships mainly with big guys, and because of this onward distribution, it makes it very difficult for us to control the the branding. So if I have to look at the threats other than the rate parity, let me see. Sorry. Other than OTAs, we also work with wholesale agents. We work with travel agents. They all distribute rates further down the food chain. Previously, and then comes the issue of paid search and social media sites and affiliate sites and all that. Paid search was a powerful marketing channel previously when the partners that we worked with didn't have access to bidding on any of our keywords, but those things have changed now. I think in the last few years, anyone can, I think previously you were only allowed to bid on certain destination terms, but any partner can bid on brand terms, for example. So if we didn't have contracts in place, that means that the partners that we work with, they are allowed to bid on all of the search engines. So that makes it a complex scenario as well. And the other issue we have is when we negotiate contracts with our partners or intermediaries, we basically offer them a certain percent of commission, for example. Now, these intermediaries take a cut of that commission and offer offer to their customers, which makes it difficult for us to control that as well. So, I mean, that's a lot about rate parity and all that. I just wanted to... is that moving? So I spoke a lot about rate parity. Other than the rate parity, some of the issues we have is mainly on the content, digital content. As I said, because we have so many distribution channels, we basically supply all the content, the images, the videos of all of our hotels through a distribution network. We use a platform where all of these media assets are uploaded, and the partners that we work with have access to this information. They integrate that with our sites and directly pull those images and content from our platforms. So we need to be absolutely clear on where this information is being shared. If we don't, then it undervalues the brand proposition. Then the other issue we have is false association of the brand. I think in the past, we have seen examples where few hotels in other geographies have used the Millennium branding and logo, for example, tried to associate that as a Millennium hotel when they were not. That creates a bit of an issue as well. And then I think this was about 3 or 4 years ago when we saw a lot of domain name registrations by people who weren't a part of our network or weren't our partners, for example. They registered our hotel names. We've got 130 plus hotels, which means that each hotel can have a unique domain name. So they registered plenty of these domain names. They used typo squatting, for example. And they used to drive traffic away from our site into PPC sites or other partner sites, which gave them a lot more choice when it comes to offering them choice. And then paid media or paid search abuse, as I said, it's not just partners. Some of the wholesalers that we work with, for example, when they get distribute the rates, they sell it directly through their own platforms. We don't have relationships with these partners. It simply means that they have access to the rates. and they can offer lower rates. So if you look at comparison sites, for example, you may notice we try and come down hard against it. Actually, we have multiple systems in place to make sure that we don't actually have disparity in our rates, but we often find that some of the wholesalers, you know, undersell our rates, which makes it difficult as well. So these wholesalers, when they undersell, they obviously need to promote their websites, which means that there's plenty of paid search, bidding on keywords across our hotel names, brand names, for example. We try and monitor that as well. And then SEO manipulation, basically using hotel names, meta tags, and you know, slogans, for example, to get the sites to rank higher on the search engines from an organic perspective. And then there is affiliate marketing. Affiliate marketing is, you know, something that is different to any of this, simply because it's a partnership that the brand, for example, Millennium Hotels, works with, for example. So the approach for affiliate marketing, brand protection perspective, is slightly different. All of this basically, and then we have issues of reputation management, and basically coming from social media sites, phishing or spam, for example. One of the constant ones that I keep hearing most of the time is our HR team sending emails about somebody getting job offers, for example, and then it looks like it's come from a genuine Millennium Hotels and Resorts email address or a hotel email address, and users are being asked to pay fees to process their visas, for example, for people living in different countries. That's something that we constantly monitor as well. There's a lot of spam emails, about order confirmation, for example, trying to take users' details. Social media, I think, is missing there, but social media is something which we constantly monitor as well, because in the past we have seen that there have been a number of profiles, brand profiles, hotel profiles on social channels, which was created by, you know, fake users, for example. Or there has also been issues where, somebody not happy with the brand have created blogs, or they've uploaded content, and which may, you know, all these things impacts branding. While rate parity is one of the biggest threats in the hotel industry, there are other areas of concern as well. The complexity, you know, in the distribution network means that we are always looking at options on how we can try to overcome this. Sorry, give me a second. So finally, I just wanted to have a separate slide on affiliates. As I said, affiliate slides have plenty of content which has been provided by us, actually. Sometimes they scrape through our site and get information as well. They take our content, our images, our promotions that we have, and you know, they try and get users to visit their sites. And then they redirect traffic to our sites. Obviously, they earn a commission out of it. But they aren't really bothered about the brand itself. From our perspective, all they want to do is get customers to visit their site, through which they can direct bookings to our site, which means that they're not really worried about how they promote our brand, how they use content, for example. This difference in objectives actually leads in issues, which means that, you know, that there have been multiple occasions where we have seen there is incorrect use of logos, for example. They're using different branding colors. They're promoting, they're sending out newsletter with different hotel names, for example. Hotel names not being used correctly, and they offer discounts, non-existent discount codes, which is a big issue in the affiliate side. All of these actually negatively impacts the branding, sales, and revenue. From a business perspective, lack of ensuring brand safety means that it does impact us from a marketing investment perspective as well. I think about a couple of years back, when we were looking at what sort of impact we have, particularly from a paid media's perspective, we saw that we had about 13 million ad impressions on paid search, in a particular month, and which if we had those impressions directly through our brand website, for example, we would have got an additional 10,000 room nights every month. So to summarize, some of the key problems that that we have in the hotel industry is trademark, keyword bidding by partners and non-partners, which basically means that we pay higher marketing costs or commissions to our OTAs and aggregators. There's brand dilution and confusion, traffic diversion to competition or PPC spotting sites, for example, cyber spotting, trademark or logo infringement. So some of the solutions that we've been looking at is monitor partners and ensure trademark keyword bidding compliance. So we started working with Mark Monitor about 4 years ago. And since then, I think in the beginning, we had plenty of issues. We had plenty of domains, domain names, which we didn't have control of. We tried and we consolidated everything. We enforced action, basically. So I think we took a four-step process when we started this relationship with Mark Monitor. First of all, we looked at what our coverage for is globally is. We looked at all our hotel names, all our brand names, and we created basically a document which allows us to understand what our global monitoring coverage is. We identified who our partners are, who our affiliates are, and who we don't work with. And tried to understand who we need to enforce actions with. We looked at paid search restrictions, for example. We created partner marketing guidelines that we issued to most of our partners. Now it's difficult to get everyone to agree to partner marketing guidelines simply because some of these partners that we work with are quite big and they don't really want to agree to any guidelines. But it's been a work in progress over the last couple of years. We have had some successes. We categorized and identified who our affiliates are, who our partners are, and who we need to enforce action with. And then worked with Mark Monitor and took various different phases to enforce action. From an affiliate perspective, it's slightly different because, as I said, I think it's a partnership from us with the affiliates, basically. So we tried to understand which affiliates were infringing, what sort of products and services were they offering. We looked at what sort of activities, how often do they send out their newsletter, how often do they update their websites, for example, where are they getting their content from. That sort of stuff. And then we identified affiliates who were constantly being a problem. We tried to take them out of the program, basically. And we also issued brand guidelines, and we had conversations with them to ensure that they understand what we are after. That helped us create, an arrangement where we constantly check and monitor what they are sharing. So that's basically it from me. I don't know if that was useful, but if you have any questions, then I'm happy to take them now. Yeah, so we work with Mark Monitor. As soon as we get, for example, if you get an email from the HR team, we basically identify the headers of the email and we get in touch with the ESP and try to understand where it's coming from. And we, of course, we advise the user who's got the email. We get in touch with them, advise them it's not the actual email that's come from the company, and then we work with the ESP to block those emails from going forward. Any other questions?
No? That's it. Thank you very much.
Okay, cool. Thanks, guys.